Tonight, federal officials are investigating a metro company for a second time.
Its crane collapsed yesterday outside Deaconess Hospital. Now, OSHA wants to know what happened. Sky 5 was over this as it happened. KOCO's weekend anchor Wendell Edwards is live with more on the company's past problems. Wendell?
Paul, first of all, take a look behind me, though. What a difference a day makes. I know it's a cliche, but just take a look. The fence has been repaired. The crane is gone. Everything's cleaned up, but there is an investigation going on, and from what I'm understanding, that won't be so easily straightened out. The yellow crane on its side caused quite the mess, but the aftermath of why it happened is about to get messier. Eyewitness News 5 has learned OSHA is investigating the accident and Rent-A-Crane. That's the company that owned the machinery. We found the company on the far southwest side and briefly spoke with managers today. They had no comment. But according to a statement released by the company's attorney, Rent-A-Crane remains 100% committed to a safe working environment for its employees and customers. OSHA fined the company back in 2010 for this accident at Chesapeake Energy, an accident that killed the crane operator and injured another worker. It took place the same year OSHA planned to implement more rules, like increased job training, to help keep workers safe. Now, that increased job training would come at the expense of the company that employee works for, but some safety experts say that could be an investment worth the cost. Reporting live tonight, Wendell Edwards, KOCO Eyewitness News 5.
Wendell, thank you. Rent-A-Crane says it is cooperating in that OSHA investigation.